We have Jimmy on the line, the guy that was the center of the article this morning and the center of the story in Pittman, New Jersey, where he's putting lawn signs, not in our town, or leave, on the lawn of the alleged heroin dealer. Jimmy from Pittman, you're on New Jersey 101.5. Hey, Jimmy.
How you doing, bud?
Good. How are you?
I'm surviving, Bo. I'm surviving. I just was a dad that was fed up. And you know, I had to take a stance somehow, some way.
How's the fallout been with this? Are you getting support, or are you getting a lot of pushback?
I'm getting tremendous support from the citizens, the groups that are involved in recovery and addiction awareness and such. But, you know, in our little town, we're a 2-square-mile town. We have about 10,000 residents, and the chief of police posted stuff, you know, that he doesn't want vigilantism. And, you know, I don't believe I'm a vigilante. I don't believe that I've done anything other than make people aware of the houses that have been problems for years.
Right.
You know.
Jimmy, what do you think it will accomplish, though?
Well, when people, we're a walking district. We don't have school buses here.
Mm-hmm.
So when kids are walking down the street, their parents can be aware of the houses that are selling this stuff.
Right.
We found paraphernalia on yards. You know, when you have a fourth grader walking to school in the morning and they pass by and they see a syringe, God forbid they pick it up.
Yeah, were you charged with anything like trespass or anything?
No. I had one individual that did go to the police and said if I did it again that he was going to charge me with trespassing. And I said, I would love to stand in front of a judge with you because I'm sure he knows you and he knows me.
Right.
So,
what do you think the solution to this is, Jimmy?
It's a three-prong. You know, you have to have education, awareness, and action. You know, and
but haven't I don't even mean to be negative, but haven't we educated everybody into a frenzy about it and kids who don't care don't care?
DARE programs for 30 years and...
Right. DARE puts things out there that, you know, that are just ridiculous. To compare marijuana and I should say cannabis because marijuana is a term given to us by the government to make it sound Mexican and more threatening. You know,
this guy speaks the truth
it's
and he's
so true.
He's very funny and agree with you.
It's crazy. I can't be funny anymore, Ken. I'm like so frustrated, you know, and I'm not saying, you know, that marijuana, go out and smoke pot. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that the money and resources wasted on going after this holistic plant could be spent on finding out where this is coming from. And it's obvious where it's coming from. The poppy fields are in the Middle East. There hasn't been a beheading video in months or even year, and this is the plan. You know, if there's no youth left in America, we have no armies, no navies. We have no one left to defend us to walk right down the streets.
All right, Jimmy, we got to run. We're up against a hard break, but wish you the best of luck, and thanks for taking the time to call in today.
Hey, no problem. I had a bunch of people telling me you were talking about me, so I had to find out what it was.
Good luck.
And I hope to work with you again soon because you're a gentleman and a funny, funny, funny guy.
Thank you. Same here.
And very round. Very round.
Very round. There's no roundness.
All right, see you, Jimmy.